What is the nature of intelligence? I think it's helpful to understand that intelligence is essentially defined as our ability to make connections. That's true for human beings, for animals, and for societies. Any living system has intelligence, and intelligence is the function that allows that system to interact with other systems and to fulfill its purpose. So we, as a system, as human beings, for example, have a certain type of intelligence that helps us to interact with each other, with our environment, and with the larger wholes in which we are embedded, with our society and the earth. All beings have intelligence. Birds have intelligence, a specific kind of intelligence. Cows have intelligence. Every kind of being has a unique intelligence that helps them relate with other members of their species, live, grow, reproduce, and celebrate their lives in the world. I think life is essentially a celebration, and that as we awaken more deeply to the truth of what we are, we begin to see around us a divine celebration. And the fact that we cannot see and appreciate this beautiful celebration is a result of our conditioning and delusion. We've blocked our ability to see that our true nature is joy and harmony and creativity, because what we are is a manifestation of the infinite love that is the source of all life and of all being. What else could we be? The immeasurable intelligence of the source of life flows through all living systems and beings as their unique intelligence. Through this, they fulfill their purposes and participate in the ongoing flowering of life and beauty on this earth. The idea that life is meant to be a universal celebration of joy and creativity is quite discomforting to most of us who have been raised in our culture. We essentially don't like to think that the animals we eat would be able to live celebratory lives of joy and of meaning. We assume that they have no meaning and no other reason to live except to be our food. Cows we think of as being stupid and slow. Pigs are dirty and greedy. Chickens we think of as being hysterical and repulsive. Fish are mere cold-blooded objects to eat and play on a line for entertainment. We have all of these ideas. The animals that we eat the most, like chickens and turkeys, we have most strongly excluded from our sphere of concern. We view them as we would any enemy. Look at what we have done with those we called enemies throughout history, and still do to this day. With any being that we're going to harm, we have to exclude them and make them despicable and worthy of being harmed. We must see them as without having any inherent dignity, beauty, or purpose. We do this constantly with the beings we view as food commodities, and this hardens our sensitivity to life. Because we cannot allow them to be happy, our own happiness is diminished. We've been indoctrinated to create categories in our minds and to force these beings into these categories. And when we free ourselves from that and stop eating them, we free our minds in powerful ways. I think it's much easier to change our view of animals if we stop eating them. At least it was for me. I couldn't even begin to think like this when I was still eating animals. It was impossible because I was eating them. But after a few years of not eating them, it took me a while, I was kind of slow, I began to see that a chicken, for example, has an amazing intelligence. It boggles the mind that divine love can create such a dazzling array of magnificent beings. Chickens evolve for millions of years in Southeast Asia, in the jungles. They have intelligence that allows them to nest, to mate, to protect and care for their chicks, to interact with each other, to form complex hierarchies of roosting, and to be an essential part of the whole blossoming ecosystem in Southeast Asia, part of the incredible blossoming of life here on this planet, spinning in the mystery of space. On a deep level, chickens are connected with a divine love that allows them to live. And this infinite intelligence manifests as their intelligence and lives as chickens, just like it manifests as our intelligence and lives as us and as all that is. We violate our intelligence and the chicken's intelligence when we take these beings and cram them into little cages where they can't move, where they can't nest or mate, where they can't ever touch the earth, see the sun, feel the wind or rain, or do anything at all to fulfill their inborn drives and yearnings and purposes. We steal their babies from them before they've even hatched. We force them into conditions where everything becomes completely meaningless, painful, frustrating, and terrifying. When we do that, we rip the fabric of our own hearts and of our beings on a very deep level. The things we do to chickens and other food animals are actually amazingly terrible. It doesn't look like it, though, to us, because we're used to it and we're born into it and we're taught that it's no problem and we've taken on our culture's blinders so we see living beings as mere objects. The cruelty the animals must endure is also invisible for the most part, conveniently hidden and kept carefully concealed from us. The fact is, though, that we are actually acting in these cruel ways, and these animals bear the full fury of our numbness and of our disconnectedness.